Hey everybody, Wesley here with another bonus seed for the church series. And today we're going to look at the question, why is church not a service? Well, very simply, because the word church, like we talked about, ekklesia, is talking about a gathering. It's talking about an assembly, about a group of people coming together. So it's a group of people, not necessarily a service is what you could do together as a group of people, but it's not the same. It's kind of like with a basketball team. They could meet together any way they want, but they might not always be doing basketball, playing basketball. They could meet in the locker room. They could meet somewhere on the street, and it would still be the basketball team, but it would not be their service. It would not be their competition. And in the same way, you could say, as a church, as an ecclesia, as a group, you could have a service, for example. You could have other types of meeting if you just go eat together. It's not necessarily a service. It's not scripted. It doesn't have a liturgy. It doesn't have like a beginning, a fixed beginning or an end. But it would still be the church because it's still that group of people coming together. So, of course, a lot of churches, a lot of people, assemblies do have services. And that is one way of meeting together, of having like a little structure. If you're with a bigger group, it's good to have a little structure, a little order. It says that the church is not a chaotic thing. Paul says it needs to have some type of order. So that's why a lot of people have a service to say like, okay, first we're going to do this, first we're going to do this, first we're going to do this. Unfortunately, people often reason the other way around of saying church is a service and then look at the group of people and they try to enforce that fixed service, that fixed order onto the group of people. This is church. Only when we do this, this is church. And we looked at in the last episode that was not true. We saw that Paul said, when you meet together, everybody has something to say. So there was a little much, too much chaos in that church. So Paul says, well, do that. Don't speak and don't shout everybody at the same time, but do it orderly, like one after the other. But he never gave any fixed order what you should do things. Other than the four things, teaching, fellowship, food, prayer that they did, they met together in a more organic, a more open way. So church is not a service. Sure, churches can have services. It's nothing necessarily wrong with them as long as the essence of meeting together, of building each other up, of having a teaching, fellowship, food, prayer, the essence of being church, as long as that still has room to function, as long as, like Paul says, when you meet together, people can share and different things, as long as that is still present in the community, then you can meet whatever way you like, as long as you make sure that you are building each other up, that you never lose that focus of why are we meeting together, to build each other up, but to make sure that the way you come together is the best way to build each other up. So having a service could be a good way if you want to focus on a specific thing. So if you want to focus on teaching, you might have like a teaching seminar. If you want to focus on just praying and worshiping together, you might have a worship evening. If you just want to focus on meeting together and just eat, you might just have like a potluck dinner together. So having a service can be very useful if you want to apply some focus. But again, as a healthy community, a healthy assembly, a healthy ecclesia, you want to make sure that all those things are represented and that every member can function, that the whole, so that we get a full picture of who Jesus Christ is and that everybody reaches a kind of maturity. So, church is not a service. It could have services, but the church is, again, a group of people meeting together. And the way they meet together could be in a service. So, I hope this has helped of reframing your mind about what church is, and see you in the next seed.